The altitude or height of a triangle is increasing at a rate of 2.5 centimeters per minute, while the area of the triangle is increasing at a rate of 3 centimeters squared per minute. We want to know at what rate the base of the triangle is changing when the altitude or height is 12 centimeters and the area is 84 centimeters squared. So it's always helpful to start with a sketch. Here's our triangle. This segment here would be the altitude or height of the triangle, and this side here would be the base of the triangle. And since this problem deals with the area of a triangle, we're going to be using the formula area equals 1/2 base times height. Now let's take a look at the given information again. We're told the altitude or height of the triangle is increasing at a rate of 2.5 centimeters per minute, which means dh dt with a change in the height with respect to time is equal to 2.5 centimeters per minute. This value is positive because it's increasing. If it was decreasing, it would be negative. We're also told the area of the triangle is increasing at a rate of 3 centimeters squared per minute, which means dA dt equals 3 centimeters squared per minute. Our job is to find the rate at which the base of the triangle is changing, so we want to find dB dt when the altitude or height is 12 centimeters. So we'll go ahead and say h is equal to 12 centimeters, and the area is equal to 84 square centimeters. So we also know area is equal to 84 centimeters squared. Notice how we're not given the length of the base, but we can find the base using the area formula here, since we know the height is 12 centimeters and the area is equal to 84 centimeters squared. So for the first step, let's go ahead and find the length of the base given the height and the area. So to find B, we'd have 84 equals 1/2 times the base times the height, which we know is 12 centimeters. This gives us 84 equals, this would be 6B, divide both sides by 6, and we have B equals 14 centimeters. Let's go ahead and record that. This is 14 centimeters. And now to find dB dt, we're going to differentiate the equation A equals 1/2 base times height with respect to t. And because we're differentiating both sides of the equation with respect to t, we'll have to perform implicit differentiation. Notice on the right side, since we have b times h, we'll have to apply the product rule in order to find this derivative. The derivative of A with respect to t would be dA dt. And on the right side, the derivative of 1/2 b times h with respect to t would be 1/2 times the derivative of b times h, which again requires the product rule. So we'd have the first function, which is b, times the derivative of the second function, h, with respect to t, which would give us dh dt, plus the second function, which is h, times the derivative of b with respect to t, which would be dB dt. Now we can perform substitution for dA dt, b, dH dt, h, and then solve for dB dt in order to determine the rate at which the base is changing using the given information. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. Again, here's the derivative with respect to t. Our goal is to find dB dt, so we'll substitute the given values here on the right into our equation. dA dt is equal to 3 centimeters squared per minute. We found B was 14 centimeters. dH dt is equal to 2.5 centimeters per minute. H was given as 12 centimeters, and we're trying to find dB dt, the change in the base with respect to time. So for the next step, let's go ahead and clear these parentheses. So we'll distribute 1/2. So we'll have 3 equals, well, 14 times 2.5 times 1/2 is 17.5. 1/2 times 12 is 6, so we have plus 6 dB dt. So now we'll subtract 17.5 on both sides. That would give us negative 14.5 equals 6 dB dt. Divide both sides by 6. So we have dB dt is equal to negative 14.5 divided by 6. That's actually negative 29/12. Notice how it's negative, so the base is decreasing at a rate of 29/12 centimeters per minute. For a decimal approximation, we can say dB dt is approximately equal to negative 2.417 centimeters per minute. This means the length of the base is decreasing at a rate of 29/12 centimeters per minute under the given conditions, meaning when GHDT equals 2.5 centimeters per minute, DADT equals 3 centimeters squared per minute, H equals 12 centimeters, the area is equal to 84 centimeters squared, and the base is equal to 14 centimeters. So it's important to recognize that this rate of change is only true given all these conditions here on the right. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.